From what we know so far, Tory Nichols is Cobra Kai for life. Even at the end of Season 3, she has a huge vendetta against Samantha LaRusso and Miyagi-Do. Many people are questioning if she can be redeemed, who is her mother, or if she's related to somebody from the past movies of Karate Kid. However, no matter how you feel about Sam, Tori is not completely innocent either, and a majority of her problems started with, well, herself. This is my analysis and theory on why Tori is the problem in her rivalry with Sam, including why she's loyal to Kreese, her similarities to Julie Pierce, and more. Let's recap on what we know about Tori so far. Tori joins Cobra Kai after seeing their demonstration at Valley Fest and answers the open challenge issued by Johnny to take on Miguel. Although Miguel has the upper hand, Tori manages to take him down thanks to her prior kickboxing experience, impressing not only the senseis but also Aisha. After class, Aisha invites Tori to go with her to the country club, which she accepts since Aisha is wary about running into Sam. Aisha and Sam are civil at first, with Tori interrupting by showing off a bottle she stole from the bar. After convincing Aisha to drink and mentioning she could swipe all the silverware, Sam suspects that she stole her mom's wallet, which in reality it was actually due to Trey, Cruz, and Derek. Sam confronts Tori, but Tori protests her innocence, with Aisha also defending her. This leads to Sam being pushed into a table out of defense by Tori. We then see Tori, Miguel, Aisha, Hawk, and Moon at a restaurant not too long after, where Miguel shows Tori his video he's working on for Sam. When she realizes who his ex is, she convinces him to forget about her and to go have fun with her instead to make Sam jealous. After hanging out at the playground, Tori convinces Miguel to go all in and they share a kiss. When Johnny is called away to visit his dying friend Tommy, Kreese takes over and begins to teach the class his version of Cobra Kai, slowly poisoning the students including Tori. When asking about Kreese's lessons, Tori tells Miguel it's not that crazy because of witnessing her mom losing her job over taking unused food at the end of the night. The world shows no mercy and neither should we. After the training at Coyote Creek, Tori invites Miguel to 80s night at the roller rink where they encounter Robbie and Sam who are on a date to get away from Sam's family. Tori kisses Miguel in front of Sam to make her jealous and begins to grow jealous when she catches Miguel trying to reach out to Sam. Because of this, Tori pushes over Sam who sweeps her in retaliation. Tori and Sam then face off at Moon's party where she challenges Sam to a drinking contest. After almost losing, Sam focuses and takes the last shot and Tori falls when she is distracted. Later that night, Tori witnesses Sam and Miguel sharing a kiss, which upsets her, and leads her to fight Sam at the next day at school in an all-out war between Miyagi-Do and Cobra Kai. As they scale the school, Tori starts to wield her spike bracelet, but before losing, traumatizes Sam and also leaves a scar on her arm. Tori screams when she sees Miguel falling, and later that night stands by Kreese when Johnny returns to the dojo. However, this does not last long as we learn at the beginning of Season 3, Tori has been expelled for starting the fight, is now on probation while doing community service, and looking after her sick mom and her younger brother. Kreese offers her spot back in the dojo, but Tori refuses at first because of her need to work two jobs to pay bills. After picking up on her hint, Kreese makes an arrangement with her landlord, allowing her to rejoin with Cobra Kai. Tori is not seen again until she shows up to assist Hawk and others in their fight against Miyagi-Do at the Laser Tag Arena. Due to Sam still being traumatized by their last encounter, Tori quickly turns the tide and also encourages Hawk to break Dimitri's arm. The next day, Tori is not only surprised that Hawk broke Dimitri's arm, but the fact that Hawk also showed no mercy to Brooks. She admits that she still hasn't seen Miguel and also makes quick work of the new recruit Sarah. Tori also finally sees Miguel for the first time since the school fight, where he is at the sushi place she works at, where he was taking pictures of Johnny before she showed up. Miguel is slightly upset at her not visiting, while Tori is still mad about Miguel kissing Sam and expressing her want for revenge on Miyagi-Do. When advising that she needs help with her family, Tori thinks he's calling her crazy and leaves. Tori also backs Kreese's plan to confront Johnny at the park thanks to Hawk revealing the location of his new dojo. Robbie encounters Tori at the probation office and she warns him that Sam will turn on him. Tori also slowly tries to convince Robbie to join Cobra Kai, telling him how Kreese taught her to channel her hate, and also inviting him to help with Hawk's plan to retrieve the snake for Kreese. Kreese tells the group that Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang are joining together, which upsets both Robbie and Tori. Tori storms off and then shows up to LaRusso household, leading an invasion and all-out brawl inside the house. Tori manages to corner Sam and still has a psychological advantage at first, but Sam is able to fight back and hold her own, ending the fight in a stalemate. Upon leaving, she warns Miguel and Hawk to watch their backs, but Dimitri makes sure that they won't need to. We need to look at what makes Tori so loyal to Kreese. Although this is very evident in Season 3, seeds were sown subtly as early as Season 2. When Johnny allowed Kreese to keep showing up to the dojo, Kreese helped Cobra Kai look strong at Valley Fest, leading Tori to want to join. As the two taught together for a brief period of time, Kreese took over as primary instructor due to Johnny having to visit Tommy. Because of this, Kreese left a strong impression on the new recruits, especially asking Tori to finish Mitch after a duel. Although Miguel voiced his disapproval, Tori seemed to agree with Kreese's philosophy as it was relatable to her upbringing and the world being unfair. Kreese saying, "You're either a winner or a loser, and there are no losers in this dojo," sticks to Tori so much she brings it up to Miguel in Season 3 by saying, "What matters is who wins in the end." When the students train at Coyote Creek, it is evident in a short amount of time that Tori is not only more aggressive, but also proficient in Cobra Kai style. This is also seen in the school fight, constantly being on the offensive and also was prepared to critically injure Sam when having her by the hair. Although Kreese is excommunicated for a brief period of time, Tori stands by Kreese when he takes the dojo away from Johnny. At first, Tori does express some regret and feels guilty about what happened at the school, as evidenced in her conversation with Kreese. However, due to Kreese paying her bills, Tori has no problem returning to the dojo. Although it's unclear how Tori knew that Miyagi-Do was attacking Hawk and his gang, it is more than likely that Kreese instructed her to go after Sam to settle the score, as she has been on getting revenge on Miyagi-Do. By the late part of Season 3, it is clear that she is fully brainwashed by Kreese, and even mentions Sarabi how he taught her to channel the hate and use it to inflict pain on others. Kreese also instructed her, Hawk, Kyler, and others to attack both Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang at the LaRusso household, as they were determined to end it on the night it all began. Tori goes so far as to call Hawk and Miguel both traitors, as she sees Kreese being the only true sensei that Cobra Kai needs. Let's also take a look at a rivalry with Sam, and believe it or not, why Tori was the instigator in most of their confrontations. Now, I do want to make something perfectly clear. Sam also made her fair share of mistakes with Tori, which I will expand upon in a future video, but this is Tori's video, so we'll be focusing specifically on her. What caused their first confrontation to go south is due to the fact that Tori not only stole a bottle of alcohol from the bar, but also the fact that she bragged she could rob anyone else that she wanted to. Thanks to Trey, Cruz, and Derek, wallets do go missing, and Tori's previous statement causes Sam to think she did steal her mom's wallet. However, Aisha was vouching for Tori that she had nothing to do with it, and out of defense, Tori did push Sam, who tried to grab her bag. Now, after all that, Tori really had no reason to go out of her way to mess with Sam even more. It was only realizing that she was Miguel's ex that she felt like she had to do something. Prior to this, Tori and Miguel only had one interaction when she answered the challenge to face him. Although the gesture to get his mind off of Sam was friendly at first, Tori did ask Miguel to go all in and kiss her. What's interesting about all this is in Season 3, she asked Miguel, "Did you go out with me just to make her jealous?" when in fact it was her idea in the first place to forget about Sam, have fun, and make her want what she can't have. Speaking of that, to rub it in Sam's face and to go along with her idea, Tori did kiss Miguel in front of Sam. When Miguel was trying to clear the air, it is out of jealousy that Tori notices this and purposely knocks over Sam. After Sam sweeps her, she also makes her injury look worse than it really is, prompting to have Robbie and Sam thrown out by security with a devious smile on her face. Tori is also very snarky to Sam when challenging her to a drinking contest. Although they were evenly matched at first, it's evident that Tori is a sore loser, even though her not being focused is what made her lose in the first place. Obviously, Sam and Miguel kissing each other was not okay by any means, as they were both in relationships at the time. Tori did have a right to know what happened, but was starting an all-out brawl at school with a way to do it. Not gonna lie, still one of my favorite scenes in the series. Kreese's teachings had Tori warped so much that she was willing to hurt Sam with a weapon. Although it is not seen, Tori soon loses all feelings of sorrow for Miguel she had at first, as her main focus is now to take revenge on Miyagi-Do. Tori is also dangerous when at the laser tag place, as Sam is still traumatized by the last encounter she had with her. When talking to Robbie later on, she admits that she was mad at everybody, including Miguel, Sam, and Robbie, but thanks to Kreese's teachings, all she cares about now is using the hate and showing no mercy. Kreese also knew what he was doing when he told Cobra Kai that Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang started to work together, as he instructed her to lead the attack on the LaRusso household. Tori tries to target Sam, but she is constantly cut off by Miyagi-Do students. When cornering her, Tori is completely crazed and shows that she has been training with Nunchaku, more than likely thanks to Kreese. Even though she is disarmed, Tori still swears that she will have revenge and that it's far from over. One of the most interesting things that I've seen in the comments lately is how Tori is almost a dark version of Julie Pierce, the only other teenager that Mr. Miyagi taught. Both either lost a parent or their parents at a young age. Prior to undergoing full training, both have experience in martial arts. Julie was taught karate by her father, and Tori previously took kickboxing classes. Mr. Miyagi goes on to be a father figure and a sensei to Julie, while Kreese does somewhat of the same for Tori. Tori is noted for her delinquent behavior as evident in Season 2 and 3, while Julie does the same by sneaking into the school at night and being defiant towards her grandmother. Their first meeting with their eventual significant other doesn't go the greatest. Julie wants nothing to do with Eric because of his association with the Alpha Elite, and Tori manages to overpower Miguel and also is not a fan of his ex. Both are also associated with the Hawk. Julie cares for a hawk named Angel, while Tori is friends with fellow student Eli Moskowitz. Due to their behavior, they face the consequences and are either expelled from school or suspended from school. Tori's fashion sense of wearing crop tops is very similar to a majority of the outfits Julie wore in The Next Karate Kid. Both have their sensei interfere on their behalf due to harassment. Kreese takes care of the landlord, while Miyagi takes care of the guys harassing Julie at the gas station. Unlike Daniel, Julie was trained almost exclusively on kicks. This is similar to Tori's style in Cobra Kai, where although she does punch at times, and that's what also Mr. Miyagi trained her on, she is seen using a lot of kicks in the fight that she has with Ned later on. Both also kiss their significant others during a nighttime setting. Julie kisses Eric after the prom, while Miguel kisses Tori after hanging out on the playground. Both fight a rival from a different dojo because of them messing with their significant other. Julie fought Ned because of him messing with Eric, not to mention he also harassed Julie at school, which is somewhat similar to Tori fighting Sam for messing around with Miguel. They are also able to overpower this rival or a male counterpart, as seen in different scenes. Here are my final thoughts on Tori and whether she could be redeemed. What makes Tori dangerous is that similar to Hawk, Miguel, and Robbie, she has trained only for a short amount of time, and has become a proficient fighter in that time frame. Although she took a lot of damage in the fight, Tori was able to pin down Miguel due to him letting his guard down. Thanks to her prior kickboxing training, she is also able to utilize this along with Cobra Kai's teachings to be a powerful striker. Tori has also displayed some grappling ability, not only with Miguel but with Sam in the school fight. Speaking of Sam, despite only training for the short amount of time as mentioned above, which was during the summer, Tori is more than a match for Sam, who has studied Miyagi-Do the longest out of the students. Because of Cobra Kai's training, she is also able to take more damage without slowing her down. As season 3 rolls around, Tori has grown even stronger and is able to take down Miyagi students with very few strikes. It is very likely that Kreese trained her even more in weaponry, as shown with her mastery of the nunchucks. Although she issues a warning to Hawk and it may be implied that Cobra Kai will jump Hawk at some point in season 4, you also have to remember that Tori was surprised and almost afraid of Hawk during his beatdown on Brux. If Hawk is also able to keep the psychological advantage in a match against Tori, there is no doubt he would win the fight. Can she be redeemed? I think it is possible, but it would have to take something very drastic to happen. Kreese's grip on her would not be broken so easily, and because of Hawk defecting to Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang, Kreese would have to rely on Robbie and Tori to lead the team in the All Valley. I would love the idea of Julie Pierce being the one to redeem Tori, and it would make sense, but as of now, it is unknown if we'll see any next Karate Kid characters, despite them being canon. The only other way I would see it happening, if she is willing to listen, is possibly a combination of multiple characters. Miguel, Sam, Hawk, and even Johnny trying to convince Tori to realize that Kreese is only using her for his own agenda. I'm also okay with not everybody being redeemed either, and characters like Kreese, Silver, Barnes, and unless it changes, Robbie, are lost causes. Until then, we will have to see what season 4 brings to the table. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. What way could Tori be redeemed, or do you think she is Cobra Kai for life? If you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing, sharing it with your friends, giving it a like, and commenting, as these all help my channel grow. Thanks for watching, stay beautiful, stay awesome, and we'll catch you around next time.